class 12. Today I have come to discuss the next part of the lesson bricks, beads and bones. Okay, in the previous video we had finished up to citadel part and the great bath present in the citadel. Okay, today we'll go on with page number 9, and in this page number 9 you'll get the topic tracking social differences. Okay, tracking of social differences in Harappan civilization. Okay, whether there was difference between the people in the society of Harappa. Okay, so that is in your book here. Okay, tracking social differences. So how come the archaeologists have come to know that the Indus people or the Harappan people, they had social differences? So two sources, two evidences have proved that there was social differences present in the Harappan civilization. So number one evidence is the burials, the places where the dead body were being buried. So different types of burial pits have been found, and from that we come to know that the deads of this civilization were not burnt, they were buried. Okay, many burials have been found and these burials differ from one another. Okay, some burials, they are just simple, plain. Okay, and some they have been found with bricks being lined. Okay, the pits have been dug and then it has been lined with bricks, and with along with the dead body on the area of towards their head. Okay, there have been the dead body has been buried along with some jewelry, pots, okay, utensils, all the things which were being used by the dead was been buried along with the dead. Okay, and it also has been found these dead bodies, both men and women, they were having ornaments, jewelry along with them. That means that both men and women were fond of wearing jewelry. Okay, so from this it has been proved that there were some social differences. Means the common people, their burials were just simple, without any bricks lined and all, or without any pottery or ornaments being placed along with the dead. But the person, the dead body with the bricks lined and the things which were being placed along with the dead body, it meant maybe that dead body was of some great, maybe the authority or the head of the house or something like that. Okay, or some rich person. So that according to that, it has been proved that there was social difference in this civilization. Number two evidence is through getting things, artifacts of luxury. Okay, what do you mean by luxury? Luxury means here things which are useful but they are not in abundance, or number two, they are not affordable by everybody. Okay, means common people cannot get it, cannot buy it or achieve it. Okay, it may be very costly, and other function of a luxury thing may be also that it is very useful, it is very comfortable. Okay, it brings comfortability. So those are some of the functions of luxuries. So the luxury material which has been found in this Indus Valley or the Harappa is the faience pot. F-A-I-E-N-C-E. A faience pot. In your page 9, you will get the picture also. Okay, this faience pot. Did you see? So this fan spot has been found in the Harappa places and also mainly in the town areas, towns and city areas, not in the village areas, and it is not found in abundance. If it would have been found in abundance and also in every area, it would not be taken as a luxury artifact. Okay, so it has been found in very less amount and in some cities and towns only. So it has been supposed to be a luxury item. Okay, that's why. And what is this fans pot? How was it made? It was a pot made of ground sand and silica. Okay, ground sand and silica, and it was been mixed with gum, and some color was also added. And after making that, it was been burnt in the fire. Okay, so it was one of the luxury material of this period, and which has been found very less. So these two evidences are there that it proves that in this period social differences were there present. Okay, now if we study the distribution of such artifacts, we find that rare objects made of valuable materials are generally concentrated in large settlements like Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. As we know that Mohenjo-daro was a city area, so only in these two areas many faience pot has been found. For example, miniature pots of faience perhaps used as perfume bottles. So these faience pots were mainly used for making perfume bottles. So perfume bottles, this perfume was only maybe received by or used by rich people. Okay, so it was used for perfume packing and are found mostly in Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, and there are none from small settlements like Kalibangan and all. Okay, these places nothing has been found, and in some places some gold items also have been found, and these are also present in Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. So from this we come to know that there was social differences present. So next point is, now we'll discuss it, that is finding out craft production, where the craft production was done. What is craft production? Craft production, that is things made by the help of man with his own hand. Okay, by not using huge machines and all. Okay, as we talk about machines, a small knife is also a machine. Okay, but machines here means what I am talking is about machines used with the help of switches and electric appliance and all. These machines were not there. Okay, so craft production, finding out about craft production. How have the archaeologists find out places where craft production was done in Indus Valley or in Harappa civilization? Okay, so number one, they have found by the help of this one. Finding out craft production, first we'll go to the what type of craft production they used to do. Okay, in this period, number one is bead making, beads. Okay, beads made of precious stones like carnelian, jasper, quartz, statite, lapis lazuli. Okay, many other precious stones were being used. They were cut into different shapes. Okay, so these were number one, precious stones. Number two, with the help of shells which are found in the sea. Okay, those conch and all. Okay, from there also they used to make beads. Then another beads was made with the help of metal. In this civilization, the people already had come to know about copper and gold. Okay, so it's also a civilization which knew about, is also a civilization which was under copper age. Man had come to know about the first metal, that is copper. Okay, so copper and gold beads have been found. Then with the help of swan, the beads were made of precious stones, metal and shell. Okay, then another craft was making of seals. Further in the chapter we'll know what is seals. Okay, seals were being made in the craft production. Number 3 was weight making. Okay, they also used to make weight. W-E-I-G-H-T. What is a weight? Weight are the measures to measure any material. Okay, like sugar, grain, all these, maybe jewelry, gold also was being measured. Okay, so these weights were being made, produced in this period. Now, when we go to the other point of this craft production, we come to the main part, that is, what were the techniques used by the people of this period to make beads? How did they use to make beads without any machine, without any scientific method also? Okay, so what were the techniques? So techniques here differed according to the materials which were being used for making beads. Okay, like made for metal, it will be different. For precious stones like carnelian or quartz or statite, it will be different. For clay or burnt terracotta, it will be different. Okay, so they use different types of techniques for different materials. And in these techniques, they used grinding, okay, then drilling, and at last they used to do polishing also. So different types of techniques were being used to make different shapes of bead. Okay, there were different shapes of bead: cylindrical, round, spherical, cubical, segmented. Okay, many types of beads have been found of this period. So you can see in your book also there is a picture of a bead garland or a, sorry, or a necklace, you can say. Okay, so this has been many types of things have been found, some craft production like pottery and all. See these. Okay, then these type of toys and all, craft production. Then see, this terracotta pots have been found of this plate time. Okay, different types of like frying pan type of pots and utensils. Okay, then seals have been found. So these were the techniques of how to make beads, how they used to make beads in this time, in this civilization. Then we come to another point of this craft production, that how the archaeologist was able to identify the places of craft production. How did they identify? How did they come to know that these were the places? Nageshwar, Balakot, these are the places where the things were being made, the craft production was done. So they came to know or locate these places by the help of, number 1, abundance of raw material present in certain regions. Okay, so raw materials where availability was more, they came to know that they might be, this must be the place where the craft production was done. Okay, number 1. Number 2, they found out during the excavation unfinished artifacts, unfinished objects had been found in some locations, some areas. Okay, maybe while doing that work, sudden calamity had arrived and those objects had been left unfinished, incompleted. Okay, thus this is the second reason to know that that place or that locality or that area was a craft production area. Number three, very important, this question comes, waste material. Okay, the waste material was also an evidence to know that place or that area or this area was the place where craft production was done. Okay, the waste materials after making the original, suppose you make a garment, make a dress for yourself. You buy the cloth, okay, the cloth, you go and buy it from the shop, you bring it and you measure it according to your body measurement. The unwanted material of that cloth is left behind. It's like a waste. It is dropped here and there, okay, isn't it? So that waste material, suppose of a bead making production area, many bits of parts of that bead material had been left behind, okay, wasted. So it has been found in abundance. So that also became an evidence for the archaeologist to come to know that place was a craft production area. Okay, so in that way, the archaeologists have found out or identified the centers of production of Harappan civilization or Indus Valley civilization. Okay, next, very important, strategies for procuring materials. How did the Indus Valley people or the Harappan people use to achieve or procure or bring the materials to their place to make it into finished goods? Okay, so what were the methods they used? Now, these methods were number one, by establishing the production centers in the places where raw materials were found in abundance, so that they would not go far away place and bring those things back to the place where they were producing the things. So it was better to have or establish their production center just near the place where raw material was in abundance. Okay, so that was number one strategy for establishing the production center just near the location of the raw material. Okay, so that was there, and that is why we archaeologists have found places like Nageshwar, Balakot. Okay, they were production of shell area. Okay, things produced with the help of shell, like bangles, ladles. Okay, bangles. Now, present time also you can find in Bengali community, the ladies, those who are married, they wear the sakha churis. Okay, so that is made of shell. So in this area, in this civilization also, people of this civilization, they used to wear ornaments made of shells. They may be bangles, beads also can be made with the help of shell. So Nageshwar and Balakot are the two places which has been found just where there is abundance of raw material, that is the shell. Next one is found in Shotughai. Shotughai was a place where lapis lazuli, a precious stone which is blue in color, was found in abundance. So there also the production center was located. Next one is Lothal. Lothal was famous for a stone, very orangish red in color, carnelian. Okay, so there also production center was located. Another one is statite, a precious stone also. This has been found in located in South Rajasthan and in Gujarat. Okay, so these production centers where all the abundance of availability of raw materials were there, those production centers were located. Number two strategy followed by the Harappan people were to go for expedition. EXPEDITION EXPEDITIONS. Expeditions means journey, travel. Not for just having an enjoyment. Not for that. Not for recreation. They went expedition. Yeah, in Christian also it might be, but they went for a cause. They went for a reason. That reason was to bring the things from that far away places. Okay, so expeditions to areas of raw materials, like in the Khatri region of Rajasthan for getting copper from there. Okay, and in the southern parts of India to bring gold. Okay, so these are some evidences which tells us that expeditions were also been done to procure materials, raw materials. Number three, contact with distant lands. Contact, having a relation. How can you have relation in that time? How can you have a contact with distant lands of in that period? So there are some evidences found by the archaeologist. And number one evidence is that in Oman, okay, in Oman, in the Arabian Peninsula, okay, it has been found that there were presence of Harappan pots. Harappan jar. In your book, you will get the picture. Harappan jar found in Oman. This jar is made in Harappa. But how come it was found in Oman? So, this is an evidence that the Oman people and the Harappan people had trade between them. Okay. So, and this jar and some copper also has been found, copper vessels and all. Copper present in those vessels have been found that it is of same type of mixture of nickel is present in the copper of Oman as well as in the Harappa civilization. Okay, then number two, a distinctive type of vessel, that is what I told you, this vessel has been found. And number three, contact with Mesopotamia. Now, another contact was there, not only with Oman, but also with Mesopotamia. Mesopotamia in present time is Iraq. Okay, and Mesopotamia also had a very ancient civilization. Okay, in your this here also you are going to study with Mesopotamia also in the next chapter. Okay, so Mesopotamia was a contemporary civilization which was there along with Harappa civilization. So in Mesopotamia also many seals have been found of Harappa. See here, the picture is there. This is also from your book. Okay, what does it say? This is a cylinder seal typical of Mesopotamia, but the humped bull motif on it appears to be derived from the Indus region. Okay, this seal is of Mesopotamia, but there is a picture of a humped bull. This humped bull has been found in the seals of Indus Valley of Harappa. Okay, from Harappa civilization. So this is one proof that there was contact with the Mesopotamians and the Harappan people. And the Mesopotamians, they knew the Harappans as another name, that is Meluha. Okay, you will get in your book. They knew them as Meluha. M-E-L-U-H-H-A. Meluha. Okay. And there has been, this one has also has been found, a long seal here. What is depicted in this seal? You can see there is a picture of a boat. Okay, that means this boat may be a depiction of trade between the Mesopotamians and the Indus Valley people with the help of ships and boats through the sea coast. So through the sea. Okay, So depictions of ships and boats on seals, they are the evidence, they are the proof that this type of method or strategy was also used by the Harappan people to achieve, to procure materials for making craft things. Okay. Now, we come to the another part, that is the seal script and weights. Okay. Seal script and weights. The next part. Seals. What is seals? Very important. Okay. This question comes. What do you mean by seals and sealings? Very important. It comes very often in your final exam. Okay. So, seals and sealings were used to facilitate. Facilitate means to help long distance communication. As in present time, when you write a letter or send a parcel without any address, without the stamp. Okay, you have to put a stamp, isn't it? Without the stamp and without the address, the letter or the parcel will never reach to the person. Okay, it will just be lying there, or it will come back to you if your address is written there. Okay, or you cannot post at all. So in that same way, maybe in that period, those seals and sealings were used to facilitate, means to be useful for long communication. Okay. And what was present in these seals and sealings? Number one, it contained name and title of the owner. Okay. Means to whom you are sending and who is sending, their names and titles were present. Okay. Number two, it had a motif. Motif here, M-O-T-I-F. Motif means a picture. Picture of an animal or a plant or a bird was there present. Why was it present? Archaeologists have just assumed that it might be for the people who did not know how to read and write. For them, maybe this motif had been used by the Harappan people. Okay. So, seals and sealings were the things which were being used for long distance communication. Okay. Like any parcel was being sent. Suppose a sack of grain has to be sent, or something useful material has to be sent. It was being tied with a rope, the mouth of the sack, and the seal was being pressed, leaving an impression, okay, on that wet clay, then impression was being put. Okay, so these were how the seals and sealings were being used in the times of Harappan civilization. Okay. Now we come to the script. What is script? Script means writings, isn't it? Writings of different languages, different societies, different communities. And here also in this Indus Valley, there is presence of script. Okay. But this script is undeciphered. You can see here some script has been given in your book. Can you read it out? No, isn't it? It is very much different. It's very difficult now. And that is why many things are not known to us about this civilization. If we could have been able to read the script, it would be very easy for us to know about this civilization. More things we could know about this civilization, isn't it? But the scripts are not readable to us. It is not understandable to us. Okay. And thus archaeologists have found these types of scripts many. To 375 to 400 signs have been found. Like in English alphabets, we have 26 alphabets, isn't it? But here we have 375 to 400 signs. Maybe like for each consonant also there is a sign. Okay. एंड द लॉन्गेस्ट वर्ड फाउंड बाय द आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट इज ऑफ 26 साइंस. ओके, द लॉन्गेस्ट वर्ड फाउंड आउट बाय द आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट टिल नाउ हैज बीन कंटेनिंग 26 साइंस. दैट मीन्स दैट ईच एंड एवरीथिंग हैड साइंस इन देयर टाइम, ओके, ऑफ देयर स्क्रिप्ट. सो दैट वॉज अबाउट द स्क्रिप्ट. एंड one more thing about the script above this time is that the archaeologists have found that they used to write from right to left, not from left to right as we write English or Hindi. Urdu is also written from right to left. Okay, so these people also wrote right to left. How come the archaeologists came to know that these people wrote from right to left? Because they found that when the writing was written, it was nicely written from right, but when it came to the left, the writer's writing became scrambled up. Okay, means he was trying or she was trying to manage the space left in the left side to finish the writing. Okay, it is scrambling down. That is why they came to a conclusion, the archaeologists came to a conclusion that the Indus Valley people, they used to write from right to left, not from left to right. Okay. Next, we come to the another part, that is the weights. Not weights are, what are weights? Weights are the measures to measure different types of quantities of material. Okay, so this civilization knew what are weights, and these weights were made of a particular stone known as chert, chert, chert. Okay, and these weights were generally cubical, cube shaped, with no markings, nothing was written, and the lower denomination of weights were binary. Binary means from 1 it start, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, like that. Okay, and the higher denominations were followed by decimals, and smaller ones were used to weigh gold, jewelry and beads. Okay. And it also has, archaeologists also have found some metal scale pans also of this period. Okay, so we come to know that this civilization knew many things about communication system, how to facilitate long distance communication by using seals and sealings. Then the scripts were there, they knew how to read and write, but we still don't know whether each and every people knew reading and writing or not, whether there was discrimination of gender in reading and writing or not. This is also not known to us. Okay, then about the weights, we know that they knew to measure things. This also was known to Indus Valley people. And now today's video session, I end up here, and again I remind you that review the lesson along with the video of mine, and time to time write down all the question answers, and in between my video session, when I say some important questions, please write it down. Okay, those questions what I discuss are very important for you for your exam. So today, in this session, I end up here. Everybody, stay safe and stay home. Thank you.
Stay home. Stay safe.
Do it for self.
Do it for your family.
Do it for India.
Let's break the chain of COVID-19.
Hum honge kamyab jai hind.
Hum honge kamyab jai hind.
Hum honge kamyab jai hind.